Chia Sanku received the instrument of power from Ndora, who has now also taken over as Fort Portal deputy city clerk. Ndora noted that he will prioritize the completion of Fort Portal council chambers, as well as the acquisition of land titles for all the pieces of land that belong to the Fort Portal tourism city.
Our agenda is our council chambers. It's completion and expansion because we don't have enough of these spaces. It is the only alternative. Quotations from the engineering department in order for that chambers to become expansion. We need a person that don't have it. To ensure that the possible whole land titles for the city plots is done, and this has been forwarded to the area land committee for further management.
Ndora also raised concerns on the poor funding of a city by the central government, as well as the high number of court cases that the city is battling with.
The biggest challenge is the constrained budget. Because we are operating with very, very tight and constrained budget. So if you look at the staffings, most of our heads of the department are in acting capacity. And we have thin staff. As far as government management is concerned, Kitere is a site to keep in focus.
In his remarks, Chia Sanku, the city clerk, promised to work towards rejuvenating Fort Portal's lost glory as the cleanest urban authority in Uganda. He challenged department heads on teamwork and time management.
Fort Portal must go back to its original story. At one time, Fort Portal city was the most cleanest city. You remember? So we used to come and benchmark Fort Portal being the cleanest. You can imagine that's the level we had reached at. To manage cities is very complex. And thank you, Kagame. It's not easy. It's a complex because everybody wants service. You are managing the city with less resources. You just mentioned there's no money.
Asaba Edson Ruyonga, the Fort Portal city mayor, called for teamwork between the technical and political leadership of the city for the improved service delivery.
We have the responsibility of collecting the revenue. But the first important person you should always think about, mainly you, the two town clerks, yes, and your heads of departments, and members of the executive, and the mayors, and so forth and so on, is those who cannot help themselves to give better and better services to the people. Leadership is a sacrifice. I'm talking about two types of leaders, both technical and political. Be ready to sacrifice. Out there during our campaigns, we told people a lot of things. But almost 1 year and a half down the road, there is almost nothing that we have tried to fulfill. Almost nothing.
Emmanuel Businge, the Fort Portal resident city commissioner, pointed out corruption as a major hindrance to service delivery.
Corruption remains one of the challenges we have as Fort Portal city. But we are lucky we have a mayor who cannot keep quiet when there is suspicion of corruption. Whereas we have the ongoing cases, let us minimize the possibilities of creating new cases. And how do you do this? Let us make the right decisions. And you are the chief executive of this entity. We expect decisions that will not lead us to courts. Where you need to act, you have to act. Because it is either way. Court cases can either be out of the actions you do, or you are in action. If you don't do something, someone can lead, can head to court. So we expect you to make decisions that will not lead us to court. Let us deal with the problem that is at hand, but we avoid creating more cases.
Story by Roger Sunday for the News in Fort Portal.